3 years before America would enter the war, when I first met my blue fairy godmother. I call him my blue fairy godmother because no one believes he existed but me. But he really does exist. Or at least he did on that Sunday afternoon so long ago in Berlin.
Nice looking man.
I suppose.
You speak English?
Yes.
Thank God. I've been going crazy trying to find someone to talk to.
Pardon me?
I'm sorry, you mind if I come over there so we don't have to holler?
As you please.
As you please. It sounds like something an Englishman would say. You English, are you?
No, American.
Matter of fact, any of my beeswax what you do for a living?
Right here.
No kidding. Well, there's a coincidence, because I was just sitting over there wishing I could write, because I thought up one hell of a story. There's this American, see? And he's been living in Germany so long, he's practically a German himself. He writes plays in German. He's married to a beautiful German actress. He knows a lot of big-shot Nazis who like to hang around theater people.
Who are you?
Well, wait a minute. This gets better. So this fella knows there's a war coming. He figures America's gonna be on one side, Germany's gonna be on the other. So this American, who's been nothing but polite to the Nazis up to now, decides to pretend he's a Nazi himself. And he stays on in Germany once the war comes and gets to be a very useful American spy.
I asked, who are you?
I'm sorry. I got so carried away. There you go. That's me. So, Mr. Campbell, what'd you think of my little story?
What did I think of it? I don't think much of it. I mean, it's highly implausible. It's ridiculous, in fact.
Well, that's okay, because today isn't when you give me your final answer anyway.
Final answer? Look, if you imagine that I'm going to go home and think this over, you're mistaken. And I'm going to sleep like a log. I'm not a political man. I'm just not. I'm an artist. If a war comes, it's just going to have to get along without me.
Well, I wish you all the luck in the world, Howard. But the worse this Nazi thing gets, the less anyone's going to sleep like a log.
Well, I don't know. Maybe. We'll see.
That's right. We'll see. That's why I don't expect your final answer today. If you go through with this, it'll be strictly on your own. Working your way up with the Nazis as high as you can go. To do this right, you'll have to commit nothing less than high treason. Even if you do live through the war without being caught, your government will never acknowledge your role as an agent. We couldn't afford the security breach. You come looking for a pardon, they'll deny they ever heard of you. You'll be left hung out to dry.
You make it sound so attractive.
Oh, I have a feeling I've made it sound very attractive to you, Howard. I've seen your plays.
Really? And what did you learn from them?
You're obsessed with the notion of pure hearts and heroism. You love good, you hate evil. And you'd sacrifice anything in the name of romance. I'll be in touch.
It was every playwright's secret dream to create the most challenging role I could imagine and then play the part myself.